Lithium-ion batteries power our favorite electronics, but they're not great at handling stress. Commercial lithium-ion batteries contain highly flammable organic compounds, which is why they can turn into fireballs when they're stabbed, smashed, or overheated. But scientists are working to change that. We visited a team of researchers that have made a safer lithium-ion battery, one that can withstand direct hits by switching out organic compounds for water.
No matter how much you abuse the battery mechanically, they don't catch fire, they don't result in a catastrophic ending.
Zhu collaborated with researchers at the University of Maryland to design these safer batteries, which can reach up to 4 volts. That's the same voltage as lithium-ion batteries on the market today. And this is the first time an aqueous battery has reached that level. In the past, battery researchers have struggled to reach this level with aqueous electrolytes. Above modest voltages, battery electrodes react with water, forming hydrogen and oxygen, and also decomposing the electrodes. The team overcame this problem by coating a battery's anode with a special fluorinated polymer. This hydrophobic layer protects the anode to keep it from reacting with water, and the coating is compatible with current battery materials.
Then we can use anything that is suitable for current organic electrolyte anode cathode, we can use it. Just replace the electrolytes and put additional coating. That is the advantage for our technology.
University of Maryland postdoc Chongyin Yang showed us how he makes these aqueous batteries. Step one, make the anode by combining powdered graphite with a small amount of binder, which helps to form a spreadable mud-like slurry. Step two, evenly spread the slurry onto a copper film. This graphite-coated copper serves as the battery's anode. Step three, dry the anode in a very hot oven. Step four, coat the anode with a thin layer of protective fluorinated polymer. Normally he would do this in the glove box, but he's showing us on the bench where it's easier to see. Finally, put the anode inside a small button battery, add the aqueous electrolyte, cap it off with a cathode, and press down hard. Then you're basically done. Oh.
So right now it's a cell, a battery. We can test it. One side is the anode side, one side is the cathode side.
So that's a working battery now?
Yeah, we need to charge it first.
Okay. The team is collaborating with two battery manufacturers, Saft and Leox, to take their coating technology from the lab into commercial batteries. But there's still some work to do. The batteries can be recharged 70 times, but they want to increase that number to 500, which is the benchmark for commercial batteries. Ki-Suk Kang, a materials expert at Seoul National University who was not involved in the study, says that the researchers still need to increase the battery's Coulombic efficiency, which is essentially the charge you put into a battery versus the charge you get out. The aqueous battery's efficiency is between 98 to 99.5%. Lithium-ion batteries on the market today reach efficiencies of greater than 99.9%. Still, Kang calls the work a significant breakthrough, and Zhu and Wang say their team plans to screen more electrode coating materials to improve the battery's properties. If you want to know more about the latest advances in battery research and beyond, be sure to hit the subscribe button.